in here and done a terrific job in coverage. You see why the Steelers like him so much.
The phenom of camp phenoms, Mike Hilton.
It's intercepted on the tip. Third sack of the game.
Third sack of the game. Mike Hilton is the best camp phenom I've ever chosen.
All right, we'll start with the loss to Jacksonville. How long do you let yourself linger and maybe dwell on that before you move forward and realize the offseason is unfortunately here?
It's going to be there for a while. You know, it's a tough loss, you know, especially having the season we had 13-3, you know, jump to the divisional round with the first round bye. You know, we felt like we had the talent to really make a deep run. You know, it got cut short, but, you know, we got to come back ready for next year.
Did you go back and look at any of the film from that loss?
I can honestly say I haven't. It's probably going to take me a couple of weeks to watch it. You know, it's tough. You know, being an athlete, you don't want to go out like that. You don't want the season to end.
Did the game feel like it was a snowball effect, just mistakes happening and more mistakes? It just felt like you guys couldn't get out of it, or what was the defense's mind heading, you know, towards the end of that game?
We felt like we were in a good position. You know, our offense was able to put up some points, and we just kept telling ourselves, if we get off the field third down and get a turnover, you know, obviously our offense is going to put up some points. We tried to take the pressure off them. You know, they were carrying us most of the game. You know, we weren't able to get those big stops in big and critical situations.
Did you guys meet as a defense, or did Cam Hayward leave any, I guess, last words to you guys as you head in the offseason and maybe goals to set or things to do before you meet again?
Yeah, he just said, remember this feeling, you know. Of course, this team probably won't be together. It's going to be some guys going, but, you know, we want to remember this feeling, remember how it felt, and come back even stronger next year.
Steelers showing blitz. They have the corner fire. He's being chased. And again, back at the 40-yard line. And a former camp phenom was on the scene.
Hilton, who's had a huge sack game. Yeah, you got all three.
Are you able to take any positives away from this season for you personally? The number of sacks you had, just the season you were able to put together?
Yeah, man, I feel like I had a very good season, you know, especially coming undrafted. You know, I had a lot to prove, you know. I feel like I'm just getting started. You know, I got a lot more to learn, a lot more things to get better at. So during the offseason, I'm going to take that time to get better and just come back stronger for next year.
What clicked for you? What worked, or who helped you?
Really, from the day I stepped on camp, Will Gay, you know, a guy that's been around, that's been in my position. You know, he really taught me the game. And as I progressed throughout the training camp preseason, just throughout the season, you know, I felt comfortable. I felt like the coaches were playing to my strengths, and I feel like I was making a big impact on defense.
Everybody calls Will coach. Seems like that's going to be his second football career. But what does that say about him that, you know, as being a veteran player who's maybe not playing as much, that he was willing to help guide you?
You can tell how bad he wants to win. You know, him being a veteran guy, he's been around, so he's pretty much seen it all. You know, he has little techniques that he could give you, and as a young guy, you try to use those techniques to build your game, and I feel like I did that throughout the season.
Did Will come to you? Did you go to Will, or was it a little bit of both?
It was kind of like a mutual thing. You know, I just got thrown in at nickel, and as the season progressed, he just got tighter and got closer, and he really helped me progress my game.
And just the entire secondary, do you feel like you guys grew as the season went on?
Yeah, man, we're a close-knit group. You know, a lot of guys are coming in competing, you know, wanting to be the guy to be on their field. But at the same time, we're all proud of each other, especially with coming to somebody like Joe, you know, that he was a big, big step in our secondary, and we feel like he can help us in the future.
What's your off-season plans? What do you need to do before this team meets again?
Get faster, stronger. You know, big part, I'm going to work on my mental game. I feel like that's where I really need to step up. You know, just learning different techniques from guys of my stature from different teams. You know, try to take the things they do and add it to my game.
Did Coach Tomlin or Coach Lake say anything that they wanted you to work on?
Like I said, pretty much the mental part. You know, they felt good about me being able to tackle and cover and, you know, just play well in the slot. So they feel like if I get my mental game up, you know, I can take it to another level.